dope. I love no rules.
Do your thing.
Do your thing, man. No rules, man.
Welcome to No Rules.
What's up, man? We back again. This is Teray with No Rules, and we sitting here with none other than Star.
Star, what's good? Star Music 214, what up?
Well, I was going to introduce yourself, but I mean, I guess you just...
already. Get
let's go ahead and get it going then.
Get to have it.
First of all, I want to let y'all know he a pretty boy. He just got a fresh cut before we started.
It's not true.
the cut part,
yeah.
But shout out to Supreme Cuts, man. We here Cuts, in the cliff.
G-Dub, man, what up?
So what's good, man?
Here, man. Here, trying to end 2015 on a positive note. You know, I feel like I had a great year, so I'm just pretty much trying to end on the right note and just moving to 2016 full stride.
What was so great about your year?
Oh, man, I went on my first tour. One of my first tour with Currency, Jet Life, the whole Pilot Talk.
That was your first tour?
First tour.
For real?
Like getting on the road, like actually being out there, hanging with the team, just the whole
thing. So where did y'all hit?
We hit Austin, Houston, Dallas, and San Antonio.
Dang.
Yeah,
tiring.
All in the span of four days, four shows, it was just straight through.
What was the best show you think?
Oh, man, the San Antonio one.
Crazy out there?
Yeah, San Antonio was real crazy because they don't have like a go-to artist out there.
That's what I was about to say. They don't really just have nothing but like the boring Spurs, but I mean, whatever.
So they can appreciate every time music comes through.
So, yes. Did you open for Kevin Gates too?
I opened for Kevin Gates twice.
How was that?
It was dope. It was dope. Both shows packed, everything was everything. So
both of the times was in Dallas?
Yeah, it was a lot of fun, yeah.
Howie, did you get a chance to meet him?
Uh-uh.
I was about to say, how is he in person? Because people...
I hear stories, but I don't really know.
But you don't really know. But it was dope, though.
Yeah.
How did you kind of get involved with that? Like, how you get a chance to open for him?
Being on the scene, being in local shows, going out there trying to make a name for ourselves, like Twitter, Instagram, the whole Facebook thing, you know, and just going out, putting out videos, putting out content, and meeting the right people.
I was about to say, you big, just listen to your music, I know you being on work ethic. Like, even listening to your song, No Chills, you were saying how basically niggas out here doing it wrong.
Yeah.
So give me an example of what's doing it wrong and how you doing it right.
Well, first of all, myself, my team, we pride ourselves on the hustle. We pride ourselves on creating something and making the most of it. So really, when you talk about like the record No Chill, it's just pretty much about like people are just, they're being so trendy instead of just building something from the ground.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? They're going out and they're trying to ride these waves instead of, you know what I'm saying?
And taking I realized something, they just waves, like it's going to be gone.
Instead of making their own way.
Yeah.
And that's just my team, myself, we just appreciate the hard work role a lot more than we do riding a wave or a funny haircut or doing something a certain way.
So how many on your team? You spoke about your team. Go ahead and shout
it's them
out.
It's myself. I got a team of artists with me, JT the Beast, Saint Rowe. You know, I got Mark Swift. Those are the crew members. I got Joe Brown, which is my photographer, my business partner, just everything to me. Us, and I got another engineer, which is, okay, Mark Swift is my engineer as well. And then we got Eddie Creek, he's the engineer, and that's us.
So it seemed like y'all tight-knit. How did you go about building your team?
Just knowing them from over time. I've known JT probably about, 15 years or more.
Dang.
You know what I mean? So we go way back. We from the same area.
And you're not from Dallas, right? You're from Ennis.
No, I'm from Ennis.
So do you consider yourself a Dallas artist?
Yeah.
Or on the Dallas scene?
Yeah.
Explain it to me.
Yeah, because I'm from Ennis. That's where I'm from. That's where I live. That's where I grew up. But you got to work out of a certain market or something.
Yeah.
Some point
in Dallas
time, you
is like the biggest market to Ennis. Ennis real small, right?
Very.
I've never really been. My grandmother was from there, and I know it was literally just like...
We'll talk about that. Maybe some family ties or something. But I mean, for what it's worth, I mean, you got to think, at some point in time, you're going to come out of a market.
Yeah. So you pretty much made a name for yourself. How did you break into the Dallas market and not being from Dallas?
Just showing up.
That's
just it. Doing what a lot of cats ain't doing, showing up. You know what I mean? Just because, you know, a lot of people were there, but they wasn't there. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
They wasn't being seen. They wasn't being known. They wasn't, you know, showing up and making it work for themselves. So, I mean... Just myself, like I said, my team, what we pride ourselves on was showing up and being active.
Do you feel like you was accepted on the Dallas scene, the Dallas market?
At first, no.
No.
At first, no. And we just pretty much had to sit back and analyze everything and say, what do we want to do? What's the route we want to go? And then we just kind of started to force our way in, and it was like, yeah.
How long you been doing it?
I started when I was younger. I took a little hiatus in between, but I'd say on a serious note since about late 2012.
One fun question I like to ask, what was the first song you recorded?
Oh, man. You know what? Me and my brothers, and my cousin, we recorded like a freestyle over Drama, Left, Right, Left. I might be showing my age a little bit, but, but Drama, Left, Right, Left, it was like a freestyle. We had like the little two button tape recorder where you press it.
Pressing and stop.
Yeah, I hope that's never found.
So,
never.
How did you start taking yourself serious? Like, at what point was you like, damn, I can really do this? Or other people start taking you serious first, or what was it?
It was a little bit of both. I think I started to see the response that we were getting from the music that we were doing, and it was like, okay, this is more than just fun.
Yeah.
And then when you actually start to have that love for music, and you find yourself going back to certain albums and listening to them and reading the credits, it's an addiction at that point. You start to care more about
going.
It. Yeah.
And you gotta keep going.
And then in your writing, you start to want to perfect it more. And then in your performances, you want to perfect that more. And just everything, just it trickles down.
What was your first performance?
My first performance, it actually was on TV.
Your first performance was on TV?
Yeah, it was on TV. Tricks in the Hat.
Talk about pressure.
Tricks in the Hat. Miss Donna Garza, she had a little, you know, a little setup, and it aired on some local channels too. And it was my first joint. I had a song out called Money Talks, and we got on stage. It was like 40 of us.
How'd you prepare for that?
I didn't. I just didn't even think about it.
Did you know it was gonna be on TV at first?
Yeah. Or did they tell us? Yeah, they told us.
You just had to go in here first.
Yeah, I didn't practice or nothing, so I was tired, but like whatever.
So what you do now when you prepare for performances?
Ooh, I get nervous.
Because you was with Gates, you was with Currency, so. You doing some big scenes.
I get nervous. I get really nervous before. My boys will tell you, like, I really don't even want to talk.
Where do you think the nervousness comes from?
Just wanting to do so well. Just wanting to win. You know what I mean? That's all it is. Just wanting to win. And just, I have to kind of, like, take a moment and look off or gaze off and just kind of, like, gather my thoughts and just think, like, it's going to be perfect. You know what I mean?
Do you critique yourself real hard? It, just talking to you now seems like you were, like, really hard on yourself.
Yeah, I think more so the team than myself. Because it just kind of all goes together, but I think, yeah.
So you don't have a bunch of yes men around you?
No.
A bunch of? We talk about that all the time. I think that's like the worst thing an artist can have around him is just like a bunch of his homies or a bunch of niggas that just want to get on.
Yeah, we.
Telling him, that sound good, knowing this trash.
Yeah, we even argue about stuff sometimes. Like, nah. Yeah, the prom. I also did a show with Royce da 5'9" and DJ Premier.
I was just about to ask, were you a fan of them two?
Big fan. First of all, big fan. I actually did a show with Royce da 5'9" right before South by Southwest in March.
I'm about to say, because he was there, right? I know Streets Freestyle for him.
He did. Okay, yeah. Quick story.
Love stories.
That morning, we was outside of Nice Kicks in Austin. I ran into Royce, and I was like, yo, what up? Da-da-da, whatever, you know. And I got a picture with him. We chopped it up. This was last year, though.
Yeah.
Chopped it up with him. Sent the picture to the Young Streets phone. I was like, ha ha, bitch.
Because you know he's a big Eminem fan.
I said, ha ha. And he called me. He was like, yo, where's you at? I was like, well, I saw the Nice Kicks. He pulled up on him. We left. He pulled up on him and got the freestyle for him.
I bet you was like, damn.
Hey, you know, more power to him. And so, but moving forward, like a year later, pretty much I got the show. I got the slot for the show and pretty much did the show. Got to meet him before. I was real nervous. Real nervous.
You always nervous,
yeah,
man.
Yeah, I don't know why.
Take a load off.
I don't know why. I went upstairs and I got to meet him, got to chop it up with him. I asked him, because I was having some problems with controlling my voice on stage. And he gave me the game. Just gave me the game. Cool dude. We chopped it up.
I know you appreciate it.
Yeah, took pictures. That was 3 days before. That was actually the day before South by Southwest. So after that show, the next morning, I went down to Austin and did some couple more shows. And I linked up with him down there, and we caught up again, and we talked, and just every time we talk, we actually still talk.
Yeah.
Yeah, and so it's just, I appreciate every time we talk.
Who else have you met that had a huge impact on you, like anybody that's influenced you, anybody that you listened to when you were younger?
I would say Scarface.
You met Face?
Yeah, I did a show with Scarface last year. St. Rowe and myself, we did a show with Scarface. We got up there and performed with him, and I got to meet him after that. Yeah, down to earth cat. He's hood. He's like real rough, gritty.
I watched both of his Breakfast Club interviews, and I was like, you could tell that's how he is. Like, it's no faking or nothing.
None at all. You couldn't pay him to.
Hey, who else did you grow up listening to that influenced your music, or who influences you now?
I listen to a lot of Jay Z,
like a lot of Hov. That's my favorite rapper too.
More than I can stand sometimes. I study a lot of Kendrick because of like his themes and the way he composes his music. I study a lot of that. I listen to a lot of Royce, a lot of, you know, Prime. I've been studying Logic lately.
Logic is good.
Yeah.
People don't want to accept it, but Logic is really good.
Yeah, I've been studying Logic lately. I had to go back and catch up with Tory Lanez and come up to date with him.
I heard Tory Lanez. I want to kind of get into him. I like the R&B side. He raps too, though, right?
Mm-hmm. He can really rap too.
He can really rap.
He can really rap.
I mean, it's a few singers that can rap. Mm-hmm. Like, I give it to Chris Brown. Chris can rap.
Okay, yeah.
Trey Songz can rap too if you listen to, what was his mixtape? Let Me Hold That Beat.
Okay.
Trey Songz can kind of go too.
Yeah, my understanding was they were going to try to market Chris Brown as a rapper at first.
Chris Brown wanted to be a rapper at first. Right. And I think when once they saw him, you know, Lil Yellow Pretty Boy. Not saying he looked familiar or nothing.
Giving the curse.
But people was like, you know, I think from the stories I've heard, even when we was younger, they kind of flipped it and was like, nah, we can kind of push you as a singer.
Right.
And he kind of took off like that. I mean, he took off though.
It's
so
worked out for him.
It worked out for him. But you can kind of tell that he liked rapping because he keep going back to it.
Right.
So, but I know you you just mentioned that you had a problem with controlling your voice on stage.
Yeah.
What are some other challenges you have performing? Like, what's some of the hardest things that come with performing?
Really just gaining control of the crowd.
Yeah.
Because, you know, sometimes you're not always going to be in front of that same crowd. They're not always going to know your music.
Yeah.
They're not always going to know you. They're not always going to want to hear an opening act. So, I mean, you have to, in a sense, first you have to make them. You have to gain their attention.
Mm-hmm.
And pretty much when we show up to the venue and I see the crowd, I size up the crowd and then we pick the songs accordingly. We said we're going to do these songs because these are the ones we think is going to gain.
So you choose that like while you're backstage?
Yeah.
Are you serious?
Yeah, it's just always the best. It's just always, it's more cohesive that way.
Yeah.
Because if you try to pre-do it, it's, you're going to show up and you may misfire on something and then you're looking like a fool.
Okay.
So
let's talk a little bit about the project. Why did you name it Calculated? I think I know you're going to go with this, but I want to hear you say it.
Every move is calculated. it's chess, not checkers at the end of the day, because you have to make moves in such a way that always add up to something else.
Mm-hmm.
You know, always adding and multiplying, never subtracting, never going backwards. Pretty much, I had the previous project in 2014 when Stars Aligned.
Yeah.
And that was pretty much about a
name, by the way.
Thank you. That was about a story coming full circle, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
That was like a time capsule for me. And moving forward, gaining a name, gaining notoriety, everything, it was all cool, but I was like, you know what, something's missing at this point. And I sat down with the boys and I was just like, you know what, I'm going to do a surprise project.
You dropped on your birthday.
Yeah, I said, I'm not going to tell nobody, I'm putting it out, I'm not going to do nothing. I said, everybody keep quiet, don't tell nobody.
Say shit.
You know, and so we recorded them with like two or three little sessions.
Mm-hmm.
I just kind of went back to what made me hungry again. You know what I mean? Just
found that motivation again.
Yeah, that's all it was. And put that project out, just boom, out of nowhere, and people just...
It caught flame.
Yeah.
What made you go with No Chill as a single, or to push that one?
That was the one people chose.
Oh, you let them choose?
Yeah, I let them choose.
I see a lot of artists doing that lately. Why do you think that is? I think it's great, first of all.
I think if you put your money and all your chips behind one song and it doesn't work, it's not the way to do it anymore. You got to give them a choice. You got to give them three or four songs. You got to give them a choice to choose from. Like, prime example, Future did it.
Yeah.
Future put out so many records, they chose March Madness. You know what I mean?
And that may be the song of the year.
It might be.
It might be the song of the year.
You know what I mean? Just think, like, the shows, when he performs that, people go crazy, and you got to let people choose.
I was just saying how I was one of those people that was like, I don't want to use the term sleeping on Future, but I was like, I can't understand what he's saying. I can't really just jam his music. But it kind of gets to a point, it's like, okay, you can't deny when this man get on the track.
Yeah, you can't.
He just, even if he by himself, especially if he on somebody else's track, if he on the hook,
he's
just like, you can't deny it.
When I'm coming home on the road from shows and stuff, and I think I'm the ounce bit of sleepy, I'm going to turn Future on.
Turn Future on, he going to wake you up. You probably ain't going to understand everything he's saying, but you going to catch that beat.
Mm-hmm. Right.
So you said you getting ready for 2016. What is it looking like for you?
It's looking busy.
Busy.
It's looking
That's
busy.
Good.
We're gonna
busy
start.
Busy as money.
Yeah, very. Yeah, a lot. We're gonna pick the year up the first week of January with another show with Currency.
Yeah, that was taking off.
After that, I got a couple of tricks up my sleeve for myself and the team.
We're gonna be looking.
You know, Saint Ro put a project out here in September. You know what I mean? That's doing well for him. So we're gonna release the video on him.
Okay.
Hopefully, I can get JT and Swift to get back in the studio and we can kind of do another collaborative effort.
So y'all gonna come with some back-to-back full force.
We surely plan to. We intend
That's
to.
That's how you gotta do it. Keep hitting them upside the head.
Yeah, and I've been working with Jay Rose, the Grammy producer,
mm-hmm.
out of Dallas. I've been working with him a lot. I think we're gonna do a full album together. Mm-hmm. It's titled Dreams Hustle Can Buy. And pretty much I'm just kind of holding on to that. You know what I mean? And it's not gonna be a time capsule. It's not gonna be anything. It's gonna kind of just be like, and as I progress kind of deal, so. Yeah.
Before I let you go, tell me, how do you choose who you work with? Like, are you one of the people that kind of like to work by yourself when you're working on a project? Or are you opening and jumping on other people's? Or how do you choose?
Pretty much it's just all depends on what mind frame I'm in. Like, if I'm recording my own project, like I allow the team to be around. They can help as much as they want.
Yeah.
They can help as much as they want. I'll always do a feature. I'll always work with somebody else on theirs, as long as they're consistent.
Yeah.
As long as they're consistent, as long as they're heading in the right direction, that's all that matters, because I do features with people and they don't put them out. You know what I mean?
Like,
whether you pay me or not, you know what I mean? It's a disservice to both of us.
Yeah. Gotta work with people that's as serious about their craft as you are.
Yeah, that's all it's about.
Yeah. So before we get out of here, I'm gonna let you shout everybody out.
Okay, shout out the whole SFS, shout out everybody, shout out Say Cheese TV, Cosign Magazine, everybody that's helped me get to where I'm at thus far. No Rules TV, of course. Y'all know what up, Star Music 214, y'all know what it is.
Shout out Kai, shout out KG, we see y'all. And let people know where they can find you at.
All sites, Star Music 214. Snapchat, Star Music. But other than that, all other sites, Instagram, Twitter, the whole nine, Star Music 214.
All right, we appreciate you, man.
Appreciate y'all.
And you got the fresh cut, the waves for the babes.
Yeah, I'm going to wrap it up in a minute.
You going to put the do-rag back on?
Yeah.
I shouldn't have told them that, huh?
Get
it's
the
no
curse.
Rules, man. We'll catch y'all next time, and we out.
Yes, all you niggas is out here getting paper. All you niggas is real, none of y'all haters. All these bitches I meet, all of y'all mocks. All these niggas is out here popping bottles. All you niggas is killers, all of y'all bout that. All you niggas is out riding with the top back. Huh, oh for real? Y'all ain't got no chill, fuck em. Too many times catch them looking. My whole demeanor, the way I grind, niggas took it. I outline how to supply, they just rookies. And I slap a nigga hand out my jaw, ain't no cookies, bitch. Created mine, I ain't lucky. This proof of my pudding, hit 35, stop, I'm posted up in buckets. Back when I was in the buggy, women's styles were reluctant. Jerome Bettis on the 1-yard line, while I'm trucking, fuck it. A dictator, this the new law. State of the Union, whether you tuning it or not, it go to you all. Who would ever thought I'd be the nigga? Other niggas, old lady, trying to get me as they nigga. 100 years ago, a nigga, English teacher called me nigga. I'm top of the charts, my cousin home now. Travis, what up, nigga? Yeah. And I ain't gotta spit it over lyrical. It's calculated, validated, salivated, surgeon, and generical. Yes, all you niggas is out here getting paper. All you niggas is real, none of y'all haters. All these bitches I meet, all of y'all mocks. All these niggas is out here popping bottles. All you niggas is killers, all of y'all bout that. All you niggas is out riding with the top back. Huh, oh, for real? Y'all ain't got no chill, fuck em. And I've been rolling for years, boy, where your whip at? Every year a new ride, even let Nae Nae whip that. If you ain't one of us at the table, I make them get back. I'm rocking show to show, it's recorded, got go up pros. It's fake, I'ma let them know. No matter, won't drink the Kool-Aid. The real gon' last forever, no matter the old or new age. Whether it's good or bad, talk about me, press a plus. I've been the most consistent, I've been the one she lusts. I never roll with the top back. I never been reckless about this life, you niggas clowns, it's the top back. My chick ain't got no book and ain't a model. I ever knew how to do was indulge a Red Bull and go full. I guess all you niggas is out here getting paper. All you niggas is real, none of y'all haters. All these bitches I meet, all of y'all mocks. All these niggas is out here popping bottles. All you niggas is killers, all of y'all bout that. All you niggas is out riding with the top back. Huh, oh for real? Y'all ain't got no chill, fuck em. It cost you nothing to keep but 100. Instead they act like it's expensive or cheaper than stunning. It's like I know your whole approach and your angle you frontin'. Or how you told us years ago that your album was coming. It's nothing to tell a sucker what's real and won't appeal to the mass. But they insist on appealing, I keep my grass cut low. And I'm expecting what I already know. These politicians of my city ain't positioned for commissions, nigga. Baby girl is a model only for Instagram. The likes just don't equal stability, so I'm not a fan. Talking about what's beneficial, nigga, I've been official. Catastrophic, I got options, I'm logic. I guess all you niggas is out here getting paper. All you niggas is real, none of y'all haters. All these bitches I meet, all of y'all mocks. All these niggas is out here popping bottles. All you niggas is killers, all of y'all bout that. All you niggas is out riding with the top back. Huh, oh for real? y'all ain't got no chill. Fuck
up. Yeah, what's up, man?
Hey, let me call you back. Hey, what's
good,
dog?
Up, man?
What's up, man?
Oh, man, I need you to buy my CD, man.
Yeah, what you got, man?
Support me, man. It's called $8. Yeah, man. Hey, man, so I'm on that bitch auto-tune and everything. Yeah. Man, support me, man.
Yeah,
I've been, you know what I'm saying?
It ain't worth no $8, but I can use money on it.
Come on, man!
$8,
man!
$8?
Come on, man, please, bro.
I need a dollar.
Huh?
I need a dollar.